In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of
us. And with your spirit.
We come together to give praise to God at the beginning of a new day, to ask God to bless us this day, and to bless others through us. Lord Jesus, you are the good shepherd, leading us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you give us the commandment of love. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who founded all the commands of your sacred law upon love of you and love of our neighbor, grant that by keeping your precepts, we may merit to attain eternal life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Mary, from the book of Ecclesiastes. There is an appointed time for everything, a time for everything under the heavens, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to uproot the plant, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to tear down and a time to build, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to scatter stones, and a time to gather them. A time to embrace, and a time to be free from embraces. A time to seek, and a time to lose. A time to keep, and a time to cast away. A time to rend, and a time to sow. A time to be silent, and a time to speak. A time to love, and a time to hate. A time of war, and a time of peace. What advantage has a walker from his toil? I have considered the task that God has appointed for the sons of men to be busy about. He has made everything appropriate to each time, and has put the timeless into their hearts, without plans ever discovered, from the beginning to end. The work which God has done. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
Our response this morning is, blessed be the Lord, my rock.
Blessed
be the Lord, my rock. Blessed be the Lord, my rock, my mercy and my fortress, my stronghold, my deliverer, my shield in whom I trust.
Blessed be the Lord, my rock.
Lord, what is man that you notice him? The Son of Man, and you take thought of him. Man is like a breath, his days like a passage.
Blessed be the Lord, my rock.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. The Son of Man came to save and to give his life as a ransom for men. Hallelujah.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Once, When Jesus was praying in solitude and the disciples were with him, he asked them, "Who do the crowds say that I am?" They said in reply, "John the Baptist, others Elijah, still others one of the ancient prophets has arisen." Then he said to them, "But who do you say that I am?" Peter said, "The Christ of God." Then Jesus directed them not to tell this to anyone. He said, "The Son of Man must suffer greatly and be rejected by the elders, the chief priests, and the scribes, and be killed, and on the third day be raised." The Gospel of the Lord.
Everything off.
It could, in incite the authorities to move against him before it's time. It could cause people to misunderstand the nature of God's Messiah. Now understand, the Messiah must suffer for the people. But then it says, and on the third day he raised, that's the time to proclaim Christ, to proclaim the Messiah. So we have then him beginning to instruct them that, yes, he is the Christ of God, but that's not going to work out the way they think it will work out. It's going to work out much differently and involve much more suffering than they can imagine. And yet, it remains true what Peter says, you are the Christ of God. And so that paradox, the Savior from God will suffer and die, but then the promise, and will be raised on the third day. Let us bring our prayers to our Heavenly Father. We continue our prayers for our country in the midst of the unrest over racial injustice. And we pray that we may together as a country move to heal the ancient wounds and the present wounds of racial injustice. We pray to you. We pray for all who are hurting, for our family members, our friends who suffer from any kind of illness, that they may know God's healing, we pray to the Lord. And we pray for those who have died, for Eileen and Floyd Briggs, and for all who have touched our lives with their illness and gone before us of faith, that they will know God's peace and joy forever. We pray to the Lord. In our hearts, we offer to God all the other prayers and concerns we have. For all the prayers in our hearts, we pray to the Lord. Gracious God, in Jesus, you yourself come into our lives. Help us to hear his words of your love and mercy and to reflect them to one another. We make this prayer in Jesus' name, who is your Son, our Lord, forever and ever.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth, the work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed be you, my God, all creation, and through your goodness we receive the word of God. Through the divine word of man, will become our spiritual food. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that our sacrifice will be acceptable to God, the Almighty God. Amen. Receive with favor, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what we profess with devotion and faith may be ours through these heavenly mysteries. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, for your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as we come towards we acclaim you. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fountain of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts we pray, by sending your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passionate prayer, and giving thanks for it, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink of it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body of God for us, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring us to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Lord, Salvatore, our Bishop, and the entire people you have gained for your glory. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face.
Have mercy on us all, O Lord, and with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be the heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor are yours forever and ever. And let us pray together as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you all. Let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are we who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but on the stable word of my soul shall be.
The body of Christ.
Let us pray. Graciously raise up, O Lord, those who renew with this sacrament, that we may come to possess your redemption, both in mystery and in the manner of our life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May ever-loving God,